Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heater mass transfer. So this is lecture number 304 on the module condensation heat transfer. And in this session, we are going to solve few problems on the condensation heat transfer. So in the earlier session, in the previous session, we discussed the theory of condensation. We discussed the film-wise condensation, drop-wise condensation, and we have seen few correlations for calculating heat transfer coefficient in the film-wise condensation for vertical plate, horizontal plate, and the tube bundle. Now using those correlations, we solve problems here. So at the end of this session, the student will be able to solve problems in the condensation heat transfer. That is the outcome for the session. We take example number one. Saturated steam at atmospheric pressure condenses on the 2 meter high and 2 meter wide vertical plate that is maintained at 80 degrees Celsius by circulating cooling water through the other side. Determine the rate of heat transfer by condensation to the plate and the rate at which the condensate drip off of the plate at the bottom. So this is from the unionized question paper November 2016. So all the problems whatever I solve here in all the module, in all the video lectures, they are taken only from the unionized question paper. So by seeing this, the student will get some confident on the solving problem from the university examination question paper. And after reading the problem, write down the given data. So the length of the plate is 2 meter, width of the plate is 2 meter, and the steam pressure is atmospheric pressure, saturated steam at atmospheric pressure. For atmospheric pressure, the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius and the surface temperature of the plate is 80 degrees Celsius. Now from the steam table, so at atmosphere for the saturation temperature, TV, vapor temperature 100 degrees Celsius, we take HFG, latent heat of evaporation, which is 2256.9 and 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. And we take all the other properties at the film temperature, which is TV plus TS divided by 2. This is 90 degrees Celsius. And we require from the heat and mass transfer data book, we take the properties. Density 967.5 kilograms per meter cube. Absolute viscosity 3.17 10 power minus 4 newton second per meter square. For water, you will be given kinematic viscosity in the data book. So you take kinematic viscosity, multiply by density, you will get the absolute viscosity. And thermal conductivity is 0.67455 watts per meter Kelvin. And the specific heat of the water is 4205.5 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So you take all the property from the data book. Then we modify the latent heat of evaporation. The formula is HFG star equal to HFG plus 0.68 into CPL into TV minus TS. So substituting all the numerical values, see the HFG star equal to 2314.1 into 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. Then the heat transfer coefficient for vertical plate. So this is equation number 1 from the HMT data book, page number 149 for condensation. So H equal to 0.943 into k to the power 3 rho square g into HFG star divided by mu L into TV minus TS whole to the power 0.25. Substituting all the numerical values here. So k equal to 0.67455 to the power 3, rho equal to 967.5 square, g is 9.81, HFG star equal to 2314.1 10 power 3. Divided by mu L equal to 3.17 10 power minus 4, L equal to 2 meter, and the temperature is 100 minus 80. So calculating using the calculator, HOL equal to 4490.87 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now the rate of heat transfer Q equal to HA into TV minus TS. So this is the vertical plate, area equal to W into L. So 4490.87 into 2 into 2 into 100 minus 80 equal to 359.27 kilowatts. So calculating using the calculator, it is 359.27 kilowatts. And rate of condensate flow, M equal to Q by HFG star, substituting 359.27 into 10 power 3 divided by 2314.1 into 10 power 3 equal to 0.155 kilograms per second. So the answer to the problem, the rate of heat transfer is 359.27 kilowatts and the rate of condensate flow is 0.155 kilograms per second. This is the answer to the problem. And we take example number 2. This is from question paper November 2017. A vertical plate 3.2 meter high maintained at 54 degrees Celsius is exposed to saturated steam at atmospheric pressure. Calculate the heat transfer rate per unit width. And the given data, W length equal to 3.2 meter, W width equal to 1 meter, atmospheric pressure, so the vapor temperature from the steam table is 100 degrees Celsius and the surface temperature is 54 degrees Celsius. And from the steam table at 100 degrees Celsius, HFG equal to 2256.9 × 10³ joules per kilogram. Then calculating the properties of the film temperature, so film temperature is 100 plus 54 divided by 2, which is 77 degrees Celsius. And the properties from the heat and mass transfer data book. So we are have the property and the 60 and 80. So we do the interpolation for 77. So we take the properties at 77 degrees Celsius. Density is 975.65. Mu equal to 3.7183 × 10⁻⁴. And the specific heat is 4193.2. And the K equal to 0.6661. Then modified latent heat of evaporation. So HFG plus 0.68 into CPL into TV minus TS. So substituting numerical values, HFG star equal to 2388.1 × 10³ joules per kilogram. Then for a vertical plate, the same correlation what we used earlier. So H equal to 0.943 into K to the power 3 rho square G into HFG star divided by mu L into L into TV minus TS. 4 to the power 0.25. So substituting and calculating, H equal to 3123.78 watts per meter square Kelvin. So carefully look at the substitution. K equal to 0.661, rho equal to 975.65, G is 9.81, HFG star equal to 2388.1, mu equal to 3.7183, L equal to 3.2 meter, and TV minus T is 100 minus 54. And the rate of heat transfer, so Q equal to HA into TV minus TS equal to substituting 3123.78 into 3.2 into 1 into 100 minus 54 equal to 459.82 kilowatts. And the rate of condensate flow dividing by the M equal to Q by HFG star, so 459.82 into 10³ divided by 2388.1 into 10³ equal to 0.192 kilograms per second. So the answer to the problem, rate of heat transfer is 459.82 kilowatts and rate of condensate flow is 0.192 kilograms per second. We take example number 3. The outer surface of a vertical tube which is 1 meter long and has an outer diameter of 80 millimeter is exposed to saturated steam at atmospheric pressure and is maintained at a temperature of 50 degrees Celsius by flow of cool water through the tube. So what is the rate of heat transfer to the coolant and what is the rate at which steam condensed at the surface? So this is a vertical tube. So write down the given data, length of the tube equal to 1 meter, diameter of the tube equal to 0.08 meter, again atmospheric pressure, steam is at atmospheric pressure, so the vapor temperature is 100 degrees Celsius and the surface temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. And we take the steam table for the HFG value, which is 2256.9 × 10³ joules per kilogram. And we take the film temperature, so 75 degrees Celsius, and take the properties at 75 degrees Celsius. So these are all the properties at 75 degrees Celsius. So we have the property at 60 and 80, then we take by interpolation for 75. So 75 rho equal to 976.75. Mu equal to 3.836 × 10⁻⁴, Cp equal to 4192 and K equal to 0.66435. And the modified latent heat of evaporation, calculate. So 2256.9 × 10³ into 0.68 into CPL into TV minus TS, substituting all the numerical values, this is 2399.4 × 10³ joules per kilogram. And here we have vertical tube. So for condensation calculation, if you look at the page number 159, so we have vertical surface, correlation for vertical surface, which is applicable for vertical tube as well as vertical plate. So we have to take the vertical surface correlation for vertical tube and substitute the equations. Remember, though it is a tube, we have to substitute only L. So the correlation only, we have to substitute the L, length of the tube, vertical length of the tube. So equation is 0.943 into k to the power 3 rho square g into h of g star divided by mu L into L into Tv minus Ts. So substituting all the numerical values and calculating, carefully calculating using the calculator, the heat transfer coefficient is 4059.1 watts per meter square Kelvin. And you listen to the correlation, the calculation. So if you want to verify, you can pause the video and calculate the parameter. You can use the calculator to verify, or if you want to note down, you can also pause and note down the equations. And the rate of heat transfer Q equal to HA into TV minus TS. So here the area is pi d into L. So it is a cylindrical pipe, vertical pipe. The area is pi d into L. So pi into 0.08 into length equal to 1 meter. And substituting other numerical values, the rate of heat transfer is 50.98 kilowatt. And the mass of condensate is M equal to Q by HFG equal to 0.02 kilograms per second. And the answer to the problem, rate of heat transfer is 50.98 kilowatts and the rate of condensate flow is 0.02 kilograms per second. And example number 4, this is from May 2006 question paper. A tube of 2 meter length and 25 millimeter diameter OD, outer diameter, is to be used to condense saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius while the tube surface is maintained at 92 degrees Celsius. Estimate the average heat transfer coefficient and rate of condensation of the steam if the tube is kept horizontal. The steam condenses on the outside surface of the tube. And the given data, length equal to 2 meter, diameter equal to 0.025 meter, vapor temperature 100 degrees Celsius and surface temperature is 92 degrees Celsius. We take the property steam table, HFG value from the steam table, which is 2256.9 and 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. And we take the film temperature, which is 96 degrees Celsius. And at 96 degrees Celsius, from the data book, page number 22, you take the properties of the water, which is density equal to 963.6, mu value equal to 2.96 10 power minus 4, thermal conductivity is 0.67806, and specific heat is 4211.8. And the modified heat transfer, latent heat of evaporation, HFG star we calculate, which is 2279.8 in 10 power 3. And for horizontal tube, again page number 149, equation number 2, for horizontal tube, you take the correlation. So look at the correlation, H equal to 0.728 into K to the power 3, rho square, G HFG star divided by mu D. So here, look at here, diameter is the only another difference. And the constant is 0.728, whereas for the vertical plate is 0.943. So, into Tv minus Ts to the power 0.25. So, substitute and calculate everything. So, this is 13,238.6 watts per meter square Kelvin. So, K equal to 0.67806, rho equal to 963.6, G equal to 9.81, HFG star equal to 2279.8 into 10 power 3, mu equal to 2.96 into 10 power minus 4, and diameter equal to 0.025. And the temperature difference is 100 minus 92. So, H equal to 13,238.6 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the mass of condensate flow, M equal to Q by H of G star, where Q equal to HA into TV minus TS, where A equal to pi D into L. So, substituting all the values, 13,238.6 into 3.14 into 0.025 into 2 into 100 minus 92 divided by H of G star equal to 0.00729 kilograms per second. So, the average heat transfer coefficient is 13,238.6 watts per meter square Kelvin and rate of condensate flow is 0.00729 kilograms per second. That is the answer to the problem. And example number 5, which is from anonymous question paper, November 2011, a 10 by 10 array of horizontal tubes of 1.27 centimeter diameter is exposed to pure steam at atmospheric pressure. If the tube wall temperature is 98 degrees Celsius, estimate the mass of the steam condensed, assuming that the length of the tube equal to 5 meter. So, read the problem and write down the given data. So given data, length of the tip equal to 5 meter, OD outer diameter is 1.27 centimeter, which is 0.0127 meter, surface temperature is 98 degrees Celsius, 1 atmosphere. So for 1 atmosphere, vapor temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. So number of tube equal to 100. So we have 10 array of 10 tubes. So 100, number of horizontal rows equal to n. So small n equal to number of tubes, which is 100. Capital N equal to number of array of tube, which is 10. And from the steam table, for 1 atmosphere pressure, TV equal to 100 degrees Celsius, vapor temperature 100 degrees Celsius, and HFG equal to 2256.9 in 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. And the film temperature is now 99 degrees Celsius, and the properties of water at 99 degrees Celsius. So, rho L equal to 961.65 kilograms per meter cube, mu L equal to 2.85 10 power minus 4 newton second per meter square, KL equal to 0.6798 watts per meter Kelvin, and CPL equal to 4214.95 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the modified heat transfer, lateral heat of evaporation, HFG star equal to HFG plus 0.68 into CPL into TV minus TS. So substituting all the numerical values, so the HFG star equal to 2262.5 into 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. And the average heat transfer coefficient for horizontal N tubes, horizontal banks of tubes, again page number 149, equation number 3. And you look at this equation, there is only one change between 2 and 3. So here in the denominator we have N, capital N, that is number of arrays of tubes. So 0.728 K to the power 3 rho square G into HFG star divided by mu L, number of arrays capital N into diameter of the tube into TV minus TS whole to the power 0.25. Substituting all the values and using the calculator, you calculate, you find H equal to 12,603 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the heat transfer coefficient is 12,603 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the amount of condensation, so rate of condensate flow, M equal to Q by HFG, HFG star. So Q equal to HA into TV minus TS divided by HFG star. Now the area equal to number of tubes, small n into pi dl. So substituting 12,603 into 100, number of tubes equal to 100, pi 3.14, diameter 0.0127, length equal to 5 meters into 100 minus 98, and calculating M equal to 0.222 kilogram per second. So the answer to the problem, average heat transfer coefficient is 12,603 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the mass of condensate, mass of condensed steam condensed equal to 0.222 kilograms per second. So we stop here. So if you have, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can refer to it for additional information. And this is the book what I have published earlier on the subject. You can refer to it for additional problems on the condensation. So I have solved a few problems only from the unionized question paper. For many more problems, you can refer to the textbook. And if you have any queries, you can write to me mail ID. And if you have any clarification, you can give your comment on the video, so which will be useful for next slides. So until then, thank you. We'll meet again.